Thank you, Ed. Time now is 7:14. Taking care of your eyes is the main focus of our next guest this morning. We welcome to the show Dr. Tonyatta Hairston. Thank you for coming.
Good morning.
Good morning. Now, I know it's probably a little early for you, isn't it?
Just a little bit.
Well, I'm glad you made it today. So
happy
that's
to be
good.
Here.
Okay, good. So I understand that you have two businesses in the city of Jackson, so go ahead and tell me about those.
I own Envision Eye Care. We are a full-service optometrist office. One office is located on North State Street across from the Baptist Hospital, and the second office is at Jackson State at 1 University Place.
Okay, and how long have you been at both of those locations?
This is my 14th year practice, and I've been at Jackson State for about 3 years.
Okay, so. And what services are probably the most that you get most often? Is it just random eye care checkups?
Typically, it's comprehensive eye care. We see babies starting out at 6 months old all the way up through geriatric patients. I think my oldest patient to date is about 104. And so what we do basically is taking care of people's eyes, making sure they can not only see well, and if they need glasses or contacts, prescribing glasses and contacts for them, but also the health of their eyes. Patients who come in who are diabetic, hypertensive, people with cholesterol, all of those things affect your eyes. And so we provide eye care to make sure that those eye diseases are not affecting the way people see.
Right. So would it be okay if we all come in one day and just have a JSU-TV eye checkup? Because we have a few people, you know, Keith Collins, he has cataracts really bad.
Oh.
And, you know, he needs some help with that. So what would you recommend for him to kind of relieve that, those symptoms?
Well, sure. You guys can feel free to come over and we'll take really good care of you. Cataracts are a very common eye anomaly. Typically, anyone over the age of 50 to 60 will start to develop a cataract, and that's nothing more than an opacity in your lens of your eye that causes your vision to be blurred. And so, depending on how severe his cataract is, we can prescribe glasses and or recommend surgery depending on the stage of the cataract.
All right, well, that's good, Keith. You can definitely come and get some help from Dr. Hairston. So, also, I have astigmatism, and I know that that's kind of common. Can you explain what exactly is it? Some people don't understand. I know it has something to do with your pupil.
Well, actually, astigmatism is a type of vision problem, just like being nearsighted or farsighted. Astigmatism has to do with the shape of your eye. Sometimes you'll hear people say that my eye is shaped like a football. Well, the eyeball itself should be round like a sphere, but with astigmatism, the shaping of the eye is not completely round. As a result, when light enters the eye, the light gets bent, causing the vision to be blurry. So astigmatism is just like being nearsighted or farsighted, but it has to do with the shape. And so when people come in and they say, I have an astigmatism, oh my God, am I going to go blind? No, it's simply a type of eye problem that is fixable or correct it with glasses or contact lenses.
And what do you do for eye ulcers? Because Spencer was complaining the other morning about an ulcer right there, and it just looks like a little white dot.
Yeah,
so what is that?
Absolutely. Ulcers can be either bacterial or they could be viral, and sometimes they're completely sterile, which means that they're not going to have an infective component. But normally an ulcer will develop from someone who overwears their contact lenses, which is very, very prevalent, and we do recommend that people follow the FDA guidelines to dispose of their contacts. Either typically it's daily, every 2 weeks, or every month. And so eye ulcers can be treated normally with an antibiotic and just changing the modality of how someone wears their contacts, making them more compliant with those lenses.
Well, that's great. Now, what exactly made you want to take on this profession?
Well, to be honest with you, I've wanted to be an optometrist since I was 6 years old.
Oh.
Ironically, my dad wanted me to be a broadcast journalist.
Oh, really?
So this is nice being on set this morning.
Okay.
But
you definitely have the voice and you speak very well. Yeah.
Thank you so much. And so since 6 years old, when I had my very first eye exam, I was so amazed with all the equipment that the doctor used to basically make me see better. And so from that day, I kept saying, I'm going to be an eye doctor when I grow up. And so from six all the way, I guess, to 18 years old, did an internship at the University Medical Center that really opened the door for me into being able to explore the profession even further. So very thankful to be able to serve in this way.
That's good. Now, does your business, does it offer frames? I see you have some glasses this
yes.
morning. Okay.
We do. We have frames, we have sunglasses, we have contact lenses. So basically full scope optometry, we're able to fit you same day and sometimes get your prescription out in your lenses with your frames and lenses on the same day.
So. Oh, that's actually pretty fast service.
Pretty fast service. Good. Depending on the prescription, we try to keep people happy and seeing.
Oh, yes. Melvin, guess what? You can go get you some new glasses. That's great. See, we have everybody here who kind of just has some kind of eye problem.
Just so eye problems
all we can over. All just go get taken care of by you. Isn't
Absolutely.
That something? You hear that, Mel? No more bottle caps. But definitely, so aside from optometry, mm-hmm. you know, what do you do as far as to pass time? What are your hobbies outside of this? Because I understand sometimes work can take over, but what do you do to kind of just yeah. let loose?
I work quite a bit. However, in my downtime, I love playing tennis. I actually played a match last night, and so that requires a lot of physical activity, which certainly helps with other things like stress. I'm also part of optometry association, Mississippi Optometry Association, as well as the Junior League of Jackson. And so, and then that means not forget to mention Leadership Jackson. I serve on the board with that organization as well. So I do lots of volunteering, which certainly brings me joy to help other people. But then playing tennis really brings me a lot of joy.
Tennis.
That ball. Yeah.
Really? Uh-huh. So do you have a good backhand or forehand?
Yeah, both.
Both? Really? Both.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's
mm-hmm.
good. What about your serve?
Hey, yeah. No soft serves here.
Well, don't mess with her. She just has it all, doesn't she? So is there anything that is coming up, any sales or specials going on with your business?
Well, this month, it's the month of Halloween, and so we're promoting eye safety. And so we're wanting to just remind parents about Halloween safety in terms of costumes for kids, making sure that their eyes are not covered or obscured so that they can see and that other people can see them. We also want to encourage folks that if you're going to wear the cosmetic contacts, that you follow the FDA guidelines. And typically, those are single-use contacts, and so you want to dispose of them immediately. So that's what we're promoting this month. It's just safety with your eyes.
Okay, well, thank you so much.
Thank
we
you.
Definitely enjoyed her this morning. We're going to go and get these guys some help because
yes,
they
bring them over.
We're trying to preserve their eyes. So
yes.
Thank you so much, Dr. Hairston, for joining us this morning.
Thanks for
when
having
we
me.
Return, yes, ma'am, when we return, we will take a look at Founders Day activities, and that's next, so make sure you stay with us.